Bottom line, when I look at a film, first thing I want to know, particularly as a surgeon, is how many lumbar vertebrae do they have? Because if they have an extra lumbar vertebrae, that can be a real bugaboo with localizing a film in the OR. Here's the transverse process of L1 on both sides here. Here's the rib going into T12. That, by definition, is the thoracolumbar junction. Then we got L2, L3, L4, and L5. And it looks like this person has five lumbar vertebrae. So that's the first thing I want to know. I want to see what's the alignment in the coronal plane. Okay, is there any coronal imbalance? The answer is no. This person has a nice straight spine. Are the iliac crests lined up? So we hit iliac crest here, iliac crest here. Is this line equal? No, it's a little tilted. Could that be related to spinal irritation or some sort of pain? Yes, that's possible. Look at here's the iliopsoas margin. You can see this white line here. This is the iliopsoas muscle. You can pick that up nicely on both sides here. Nice, normal, balanced spinal canal. We see the spinous processes here and the pedicle, outline of the pedicle here and the outline of the pedicle here. So this is a good straight-on view. This is what we want to see. Pedicle, spinous process. And so what I'm looking at here, we also can see the edge of the liver here. Right here is liver, okay? Spleen over here, stomach, okay? So this is kind of what I'm looking for on an AP view. And then on a lateral, we want to see what's the lordosis look like here. Does this person have normal lordosis?